So is there a formula for success? Is there something that we can pull out of this that we can use? And I'm gonna argue that there's not necessarily like a number. Optimum isn't a number. It's gonna be two kind of matrix-driven processes. The first one is that under ideal circumstances, we should be able to transition seamlessly between a wide variety of fuel substrates. If you had a big whack of carbs, it wouldn't leave you drooling on yourself a couple hours later. If you had to go a day without eating, like I did because I had some food poisoning and I haven't eaten, you know, all day, and what I did eat from yesterday didn't stay with me all that long, and it would be largely unaffected because I've been in a ketogenic state for a long time. So it's not that big of a deal for me. So I would argue, though, that a seamless transition between fuel substrates is a laudable characteristic, and it's something that we should be pushing for all the time. We should always be pushing for a little bit more metabolic headroom, the ability to deal either with a little more carb or a little more fat, although there are situations in which that really tightly controlled macronutrient ratio will be valuable. The other point that I'd make is optimum is going to be a relative lack of modern degenerative disease, and I don't think there's really any huge drama around that. I will make the point that when we're talking about the lack of modern degenerative disease, it's really important that we pick our definitions of what normal or healthy is carefully. So this is an example of, let's see, is there a laser pointer on here? Oh, maybe not. But the top one is a United States population. The bottom is a pre-Westernized population, and they're basically being checked for oral glucose tolerance. And what's so interesting with this is that even though this non-Westernized population on the bottom, they do see a mild decrease in their ability to metabolize glucose with age. So they're losing a little bit of metabolic flexibility. At the end of their life, they're better than anybody was in the Westernized population early in life. So when we are trying to define what normal is, we need to be very careful.